Alright, people of YouTube, as you can see, because of this camera, there are minus three seats, three more, and the three behind it. Now, everyone in this section has been displaced at one point or another. All because of the stupid camera.
What is up, YouTube? I am EasilyPleased23, and I am anything but pleased after our adventure into WrestleMania 31 yesterday. As me and my family, we went to WrestleMania, which sounded cool, and we thought it was going to be all good when we got there. Except once we got there, we were told that two of our seats out of the four of our... We had four seats, and two of them were taken by a stupid camera. And we were forced to separate. And that wasn't even the worst part. Because as me and my uncle, we held on to the two that weren't taken by the stupid camera. My dad was forced to walk down to two different lines. One line he was forced to go to after 20 people, he was forced to go to another line and wait another 20 people. And then my brother, who is the enormous wrestling fan, was forced to... They both missed the first two matches of the thing, which were the Tag Team Fatal 4-Way and the Andre the Giant Battle Royal, which sucked because they missed both of those. And then we weren't the only ones obviously having those problems, because as big as a man, you're obviously going to see lots of people just having issues and things. But as we went on, more and more people, because of the camera, were displaced. And that camera took up at least 12 chairs, because we were in row 18, row 16, 17, 18, and 19. Three chairs on the ends of those rows were taken. And then you couldn't walk through those because of the caution tape and things. So, and the worst part was, because our seats were right there next to... My seats were right next to the camera thing. If you had to go to the bathroom, you had to go to the right, all the way to the right side to go to the bathroom, which means you had to go through a shitload of people just to go and, like, go to the bathroom or even get food, which would have been a nightmare. And the sad thing was, the cameraman... Well, maybe it wasn't sad that he wasn't there the whole time, because once he left, we were just leaving. We were just walking through the tape, tearing the tape. We didn't care anymore, because we were all pissed off. Because of that camera and all... So there was a mass of just displaced people everywhere. Because, I don't know, if the Ticketmaster thing screwed up or something, I don't know what the hell happened. Because even a family of eight who was sitting in front of us, they initially had two pairs of four tickets that were separate, like far away from each other, and they wound up like upgrading so eight were together. But then for some reason their tickets clashed with another family, and they were forced to go and deal with that, and they were forced to move. And then more people that were sitting beside us, they couldn't even find their seats, and then when they did, they had to go all the way around just to get in. And it was a nightmare because of that stupid camera. Because of the camera thing, I couldn't enjoy at least half the show, because it was horrible. I couldn't believe they did that. And then the excuse they gave my dad, they said that the WWE were the ones that suddenly went and decided to go and change up things and stick the camera in that corner. Which I don't understand what the hell he was even doing in that corner. Because from my viewpoint, he wasn't going to get anything. Because the ring had four posts that had like lights and laser lights that would go along with their animations with Anna the Ring and the Titantron. And the pole was in the way of the entrance ramp. Right in the center, so halfway through the entrance ramp, you'll lose the wrestler or the people who are coming down it. So there was really no reason for that camera to be there. I don't understand. And then when he was up there, he was only up there for like 10 minutes at a time, and he was only up there twice, which I didn't get. So we sacrificed two seats and had all this trouble just for fucking 20 minutes of footage that's I don't even know if it's going to even be used. I don't know. It was weak as hell. And that wasn't even... That was just like this... That just fucked it up for me. Because I was sitting there, you know... most people would like to sit there and enjoy it, but then it, for the 30 people, well, maybe for like the 20-something people that were around us that couldn't get to their seats because other people got pushed away from their seats and they were just trying to find seats in the area. And then those people, they got moved eventually by the working people, by the ushers. Oh, those poor ushers, they were getting screamed at the whole time. Just destroyed because people just, what the fuck do you mean my seats are locked? What the fuck's wrong with you? All this shit, it was crazy as hell. And of course, other complaints were, it's like viewing points, because the new seats where my dad got with my brother, they technically got closer and like more to the center area, but the bad thing was they couldn't, they were in a medium where they couldn't see the screen, which is usually what you would do when you sit far away like we were, because the ring is really small, and you're not going to force your eyes the whole time to stare at the ring. You want to stare at the screen. Well, my dad said from their viewpoint, they couldn't see the screen, so they just had to force themselves to stare at the ring, which sucked because that was like an upgrade when our seats were actually gave us the viewpoint to see the screen, the Titantron. I guess you would call it the Titantron because it was just like, I guess that would be the scoreboard in Levi Stadium. I don't know. That was my first time in Levi. Stadium's nice. It's just one really fucked up experience there. And see, it wasn't just, okay, so without the 12, now without those 12 seats, there was other problems too, because when the wrestlers were entering the ring, you know, how they pose and they look at the camera and all these things, for everyone that was really far away, they weren't going to be able to see what The Rock was doing or anything, because he, you know, he'd come out and he'd do the flex, or Cena go stare at the camera and say something. The Titantron would keep playing their loop the entire time. And the only time it didn't was when Bray Wyatt came out. Now, he was the only one that actually did correctly because they actually followed him the whole time with the camera. Which, it's like, why didn't they do that in the beginning? They just, everybody else is like, screw, after you roll through the video like 8 times, people are sick of it. It's like, why couldn't they just show some of that? It's like, this isn't the normal basketball arena where it's like they're closer and you can see better. No, this is a football stadium. That is farther away. The video dude should have been like, let's just snap to them. Because The Rock was doing things, and Cena was doing things, you know, interacting with the fans, and all we could see is the stupid Titantron file footage that was rolling. And then eventually when they get in the ring, then after they're both in, then you finally get a view, then you get your view of them. And, oh yeah, and speaking of the Titantron, there were 5 lights in front of the screen that, for some reason, halfway through the show, because it's daylight, 3 of them came on, and they were really bright. And then a few people around me and me, whenever we were trying to watch the screen, we were blinded because, for some reason, they were really bright white lights. We didn't know if they were warming up or not, but they were blinding us. And the people with glasses, like I have, we were getting, like, glare because of how bright they were. So we were that was pretty weak. Oh, and the Roman Reigns entrance. He entered when him and Brock actually fought. It was actually getting dark, so they could at least put the spotlight on him or something. Because by the time me and my uncle were able to find him, he was already in the ring. There was already just a mass amount of people, and then of course there were douchebags who were like, "Oh, look, he's coming from here." You know, they're pointing everywhere, so then you're just being dicks. But that doesn't matter. It's like they could at least stuck him with a spotlight. By the time he entered, it was like, okay, he's in now. Fine. That experience was a lot more painful than I thought it would be. Especially after the amount of money my dad spent or whatever he did. Because I started to enjoy it, like, halfway through. I think it was after the Divas match, I started to, like, actually settle in. Because then it was like, okay, finally, people have gotten most of their seats. Or gotten exchanged, and there's less, and the fucking cameraman stopped coming, whatever. So, that was a pretty bad experience to start off WrestleMania 4 for us. And I know we weren't the other ones, considering my dad said there was at least 40 people in those lines fighting to try to get their right tickets. But I don't know whose issue it was, could it be Ticketmaster's issue? Because multiple seats were in the same area, and like they're selling them and they weren't getting taken out of the system, or was it WWE? Because, well, yeah, well, for our, in our case, it was, because the guy selling us our tickets said he doesn't sell seats that are like obscured view and all that thing. But it's like, I guess there might be a thing in their contracts that say, oh yeah, we can see the camera wherever we want and not warn anyone. Because that was bullshit. You know, my brother was crushed. He couldn't, because he's way more of a fan than I am. You know, I'm not hardcore like he is, and he got fucked. And he's forced to walk around and watch that shit. Ugh. So, that was a WrestleMania experience. Wasn't a good one. I could have just sat at home, we could have just sat at home with our $9.99 and watched it in HD and not missed anything. But I guess the same grace was as like how cool the people were there and, you know, and like the interaction with the people, which is nice to have, I guess, because I guess it's a nice experience at least once. But that's all I really want to do is experience once, because now I feel a little traumatized after sitting there. Your seats are not open. Two of them aren't. What the fuck? You know, and screaming at the usher ain't gonna solve anything. Okay. So, I'm not even gonna talk about the matches. I'll make another video if I ever even feel like that. But this was just my complaints. For other people who had other issues, drop a comment. Talk about your WrestleMania horror story, sporting event horror story. Man. Oh, and for all those people, I smashed their feet when I was trying to go to the bathroom at one time. I'm sorry. Because, God damn, it was horrible. All right. See you guys later. Bye-bye.